We're here at Quality Falls, which is our second waterfall we're trying to hit. Because as you can see, the weather isn't great. Caught up in a left-hand slide. Stuck still, colorblind. Mom.
Yes.
Wait, let me make sure I'm actually recording. Here we go. Mom.
Yes.
Are you excited to be doing our first real hike of the trip?
Yes, I am.
Also, I should mention, as you can maybe see, I have the drone on me, so we're gonna try to get some cool drone shots of Quality Falls. Something a little bit reckless.
Let's get the drone.
This has been Quality Falls. I'll see you back at home. There's one more thing we have to do today, and that's go on another hike. All right, you guys, we're here, and we're gonna do the Flatbed Falls hike. This is the same location. Here, you can even see the Welcome to Tumbler Ridge sign. This is the same location as the overhanging rock pool, which is actually what it's officially called, that was featured in Memories last year. But we're doing a different hike, so we're not gonna see that again, because quite frankly, with snow and stuff, that wouldn't be that much fun. Walking on the clouds unknown. Here we are.
Well, that was ridiculous.
Not as impressive looking as the other ones.
No, but still.
Well, we'll see how much more impressive looking they look when we get the drone up.
That's right.
Okay, I take it back.
It's nice.
These falls are actually pretty nice. You can get a lot closer to them here. I gotta be my love for you. Are you gonna be my love? slightly sketchy drone flight complete. That was pretty fun. The more observant of you probably realize that I'm filming with a different drone. I'm filming with the Phantom 3 4K as opposed to the standard, which is what I actually have. They're actually much more different than one would first think. Like, there's much more than just the camera. I don't know if I'm gonna actually make a video about it though, but it was fun. It was a good flight. This falls is pretty cool. Anyways, we're now just basically gonna have some snacks right on the edge of this here cliff. Let's go. I figured I should mention, because I haven't earlier, I have since kind of immigrated to this room because it's a lot less depressing than the basement. Like, look at this. It has a window. The basement didn't have a window, and that sucks. So I can even, like, time-lapse out of here if I feel so inclined. Speaking of time-lapses, I should probably set one up as it gets darker. For time-lapse work, actually, let me show you that right now. Okay, sorry about that. As I was saying, for time lapses, especially the long night ones, I've been using the GoPro, actually, and it's actually quite convenient. This is a Hero 5, at least I can't speak for the older ones, but it has a whole night time lapse mode. It's just photos, you have to string up the video yourself, but that's easy enough to do and gives you better editing, it makes editing easier, I'm trying to say. I should do night time lapses with this camera, especially just because, well, here are some photos I took last night. I didn't put them in the vlog, but I'll take some more of this tonight as well. But here are some photos I took last night with this, and as you can see, I mean, it's not bad for low light performance. Clouds kind of screw things up. I think that's what I was going to say. It's kind of cold out here. Back inside. Can you see me at all? It's really dark out here. Maybe you can. Go like this. Hi. Vlogging on the GoPro here because low light video recording is gonna look like garbage either way, and I'm using this to actually take the photos. So as you cannot see, it is a relatively clear night. I'm sorry. Here's a photo taken with the camera as a better reference. So I'm gonna show you basically, I'm gonna try to take a time lapse of this camera and a time lapse with this GoPro. And then basically we'll end the vlog on that note, because I mean, it's dark and there's not really anything left for me to do. I'm a shark, gonna learn and slide.